This is the movie poster for Silence of the Lambs. It is one of my favorites, and in 2006 it actually won an award for its design. If you pay attention, you'll notice that the pattern on the back of the moth is meant to look like a skull. But if you look even closer, you'll see that the skull is actually made of seven women forming the shape of it, which is not only a great detail, but a fantastic metaphor about the film. Just try not to stare at it too much. See, I spent the majority of my time doing a whole lot of research about film history and the movie industry in general. Essentially, I'm that annoying person who is constantly stopping the film just to lay out some obscure information that is mildly interesting at best. And since you're part of the film club, I'm going to share some of it with you. So you can annoy the people around you too.
25.
According to a survey conducted by the American Film Institute, the most memorable movie quote comes from the 1939 film Gone with the Wind, and it is this one.
Frankly, my dear, I don't give a damn.
24.
Back in the day, movie trailers used to be shown after the film, and that's where the name comes from, because they were essentially trailing after it.
23.
The same exact newspaper has appeared in hundreds of movies and TV shows throughout the years. The reason? It is much cheaper and easier to use this prop rather than making a new one.
22.
If you count cameos and voice acting, the highest grossing actor would technically be Stan Lee.
21.
This is Spinal Tap is the only movie to be rated out of 11 stars on IMDb. And the reason is this scene in particular.
If you can see,
yeah,
the numbers all go to 11.
20.
The 1927 silent film Napoleon had a sequence towards the end which magically turned into a widescreen. It was achieved by using different projectors on three separate screens side by side.
19.
Night of the day of the down of the sun of the bride of the return of the revenge of the terror of the attack of the evil mutant hellbound flesh-eating crawling alien zombified subhumanoid living dead part 5 is the longest movie title in the world. You may have not heard of the name Don LaFontaine, but you have definitely heard his voice.
Imagine if your fears were real.
Over the course of his career, he recorded more than 5,000 movie trailer voiceovers and essentially dominated the industry.
17.
In order to avoid crowds gathering and things leaking out from set, it is a common practice for big budget movies to use a secret codename during production. Star Wars, for example, was filming under the name of Space Bear.
16.
In 2002, Steven Spielberg graduated college more than 30 years after dropping out. And the student film he turned in? The Schindler's List.
15.
This is the Wilhelm Scream. It is, without a doubt, one of the most popular sound effects in film history, and at this point, it is basically an inside joke for filmmakers to put it in their movies.
14?
The very first Academy Awards ceremony was held on May 16, 1929, and it only lasted for about 15 minutes.
13.
With a total duration of 6 minutes and 44 seconds, the ending credits scene in the 2005 movie Kids in America holds the record for the longest kiss in film history.
12.
It is estimated that between 75 to 90% of all silent films ever made are forever lost.
11.
Twin films is a Hollywood phenomenon in which two movies with pretty much the exact same plot are released around the same time by two different studios. Sometimes it is a coincidence, but more often than not, it is much more complicated.
Train?
The 1905 silent film The Little Train Robbery is the very first parody movie. On the top of that, both this one and the original it is making fun of were made by the same director.
9.
Airplane is the funniest movie ever made, and that is a fact.
8.
3D movies go all the way back to the beginning of the 20th century, with The Power of Love being the first 3D feature film to be screened in 1922.
7.
The 2017 movie Lost in London is the first movie to be live streamed into theaters. It was filmed in a single take and broadcasted live to over 500 theaters all across the United States.
6.
When a character in a movie can hear the music and interact with it, it is called diegetic music.
5.
Back in the 70s, it was common practice for movies to premiere in stages across different cities in America. This all changed, however, when Chow's opened from day one in more than 400 theaters all across the country. This allowed it to become the very first summer blockbuster and essentially changed the way studios release their movies even to this day.
4.
The phrase cut to the chase comes from the 1920s, when silent films would often end with a big and exciting chase sequence. Studio executives wanted to make sure the audience doesn't get bored waiting for it, so they would advise filmmakers to cut to the chase quicker.
3.
The very first fully CGI character appeared in the 1985 movie Young Sherlock Holmes.
2.
The famous Hollywood sign actually used to read Hollywood Land, and its original purpose was to promote the housing development in the area.
1.
It is not uncommon for animated movies to change some details in order to make it relatable for different audiences around the world. And on top of that, all Pixar movies are sharing the same universe. Not again.